Turn slight left onto Terminal 4 departing flights and then keep left. Keep left onto departing flights. In 0.3 miles, the destination is on your right.
Okay, now we're going to South African Airways. Should be toward the far end of the terminal, I believe. Their ticket counter, anyway.
Cape Town, by way of Johannesburg.
Cool. Way cool.
Cool the mask down to start the flow of oxygen. Place the mask over your nose and mouth. Secure it with the elastic band. Exit door in an emergency. Please open the exit door as demonstrated. Exit slides are available at every main exit. This Airbus 340 has 10 emergency exits. There are 4 main exit doors forward of the wing and 4 main exit doors aft of the wing, as well as 2 overwing exits. There's a safety caution. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask any of our cabin crew, who would be more than willing to assist.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of all of us at South African Airways, we wish you an enjoyable flight, and we thank you for flying with us.
Thank you. welcome to Owatambo International Airport, where the local time is now 5 minutes to 8. The outside temperature, 15 degrees Celsius.
Next to it.
Video, which will be screened shortly. Cabin crew, your positions for safety demonstration video.
Thank you.
come to Cape Town, kindly remain seated with your seatbelt fastened until the aircraft has come to a complete stop as a seatbelt.
No. Oh, so you're in a group?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cape Town, South Africa. My name is Ranima, and we'll be taking you to the hotel. Our driver today's name is Ernest.
Hey, Ernest. Hi, Ernest.
I'm sure you must all be very tired. You've got a very, very long journey behind you. The good news is that the hotel is not too far away. It should take us about half an hour to reach the hotel. But we're going to take a quick drive, orientation drive through the V&A waterfront area, and that will take about another 15 minutes. So we should be reaching the hotel in about 40 to 45 minutes. It's perfectly safe for you to walk around in the city center anytime during the day only. At night, we've got this phenomenon where the shops and offices close in the city center, everybody goes home, and then it becomes quiet and deserted, and then it's not safe for you to be walking around in the city any time of the day or night. So that's what I would recommend for dinner in the evenings. Take the shuttle to the V&A waterfront, and then you know that it's safe for you to be walking around at the V&A area at night as well. And the same goes for western side, so this is a different angle, that's why it looks very different from this side. Now back to we go to the lower cableway station. You purchase your ticket to go up to the top of the mountain in the cable car. This tour excludes the cost of the cable car ticket, quite simply because that is weather dependent and the weather is not always suitable to go up to the top of a mountain. However, the weather forecast for the next few days is looking quite good. The cost of the cable car ticket is about 300 rand, which I think is about $20, just over $20. After that, we'll take a drive-through tour of the city center, where I'll point out all the historical and cultural buildings to you, important buildings. I'll also give you some information about the historical background of the city of Cape Town. If the time allows it, we will also be visiting the South Africa National Museum. And once again, if we do have time, we'll be taking a walk through the city center back to the hotel as well. So that's scheduled for tomorrow morning. Then in the afternoon, we have the half-day cultural tour. Now, as we drove along, you must have noticed the shacks on either side of the road as we left the airport. Those are called the townships. Now, during the apartheid era, black people were forced to live in the townships. They were not allowed to live anywhere else. So the afternoon cultural tour takes you into the townships. You get to meet and interact with the locals, and it is really an eye-opening and a very humbling experience. And you also get a good knowledge of the more recent political history of South Africa, I would say, over the past over the last century. Then the following day, on Thursday, we've got a beautiful full-day Cape Peninsula tour. Now, the city of Cape Town is situated on the peninsula, and the city is on the northwestern side of the peninsula. On that tour, we take a drive all the way down to the southernmost tip of the peninsula. We start off on the western side, and then we drive back up along the eastern side. So it's a really... And in the distance, where you see the high-rise buildings, that's the city center. Cape Town is quite a big city. We have a population of about 4.2 million people, but it's spread out over quite a large area. Windows, that area is called the Silo District, that's the Silo Hotel. And connected to that is a new museum which opened up about the African art. And then the ferry that goes.
That gorgeous.
Yeah.
Welcome to Cape Town. View from our hotel elevator as we go down to the lobby. The Woolworths right across the street. Mountain up there, look at that.
And the ocean.
And the ocean, right here.
Gonna have to go up.
Lucci's, our first restaurant in Cape Town.
Okay, it's like one.
This is for the people watching the video. This is before the shark dive, okay? And we'll try to get a picture of his remains after the shark dive.
I may lose it if I sign a waiver. I'm done.
Good morning.
Good morning. Okay, tip one, ground floor. And that was another shot of you going up and down the elevator. Okay. Do that.
What?
Because I got enough shots of you going up and down the elevator. Table Mountain. That is wild.
It's beautiful.
Whoops. Did we hit? We're getting on elevators and we're not hitting the buttons that go down.
Having a good day?
Yes. And you?
Okay, okay.
Good.
Glad you're here. It's my good day. You must look after me now. Yes, I think so. Depending on where you're going.
Good plan, Fran.
Now it's a little bit more than that, right? What's 14 into 280, right? Yeah, that's not much more. Probably 20 somewhere. All right.
This building here on the left, these three are new.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, but this has been long been inside.
Get the Robben Island ferry down here?
Mm-hmm. Yes, it's down the other side.
Yeah, we gotta go there. Uh-huh. What is it, tomorrow, Fred?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good place to go to.
Can't come to Cape Town without seeing that.
Yeah. Nice cars for you there. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Behind the glass. Ferrari.
Ah. Yeah. Expensive.
Expensive.
A lot of construction going on. Yes, the economy's good, huh?
Yes.
Oh, we're going to the mountain, baby. Oh, look. To your left, man.
Mm-hmm.
It's a public school for your children?
Yes.
Go through high school?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
And then you pay for college?
Pay for college, pay for everything.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Now, are the schools now, after apartheid, they're mixed?
They're mixed, but they're expensive, you know, to keep the poor students away. They make it too expensive.
Now, are you allowed to live wherever you want if
yes,
you can afford it?
If you can afford it, yes. No problem.
but not many. How's the, I mean, the rise of black people? Are they getting better jobs now to be able to afford some of the nicer things?
Yeah, well, depending on your education and your experiences.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
So opportunities are there?
Opportunities are there, but, you know, they have some regulations, you know, they have some... They make it not easy for us to... They can say it's legal, but there's lots of...
Still roadblocks in your way.
Yes.
Ah, the American. Yeah. Uh-huh. So that sounds like the American way.
Okay.
They do the same thing back in the States. Thing,
yeah. Yeah. It's a real nation.
So for dinner we have reservations at a place called Mama Africa.
Ah, that's in Long Street, yes.
Is it good?
That Long Street?
It's good.
It's good?
Love music, yes. African music as well.
I do. I love Jonathan Butler.
Okay.
You miss tequila?
You want to spend some few times here? For...
No.
You want us to shop here?
No.
Not shopping, okay.
Okay. Hugh Masekela. You familiar
yeah,
with
yeah, yeah, very much so, yes, 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 yes. I have some African music here with me, please. You can listen to that as we go along.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. If you choose a cost to have for gasoline for the car?
I have about 16 rands odds for a liter of 93.
60?
No, 16.
16.
Oh, okay.
Not too bad, but for us it's too bad.
That's fabulous, right?
Yeah.
We could afford to live here, right?
Yeah, we could.
Yes. Come and live here. You know your hotel there, Cape Sun?
Right.
That's where Mandela used to frequent by the time he was alive.
That's where Mandela was staying?
Yes.
He liked
going to the hotel for tea. For having some tea in the hotel there, Cape Sun.
Really?
That's where we met him. That's where I met him, you know, to greet him.
Wow, Mandela used to stay in our hotel when
Not
he came.
Not staying. So going visiting, you know, going for tea.
Oh, really?
Yeah, last time he goes there for tea.
Ah.
Yes.
So we picked a good hotel.
Yeah. I met him there two times. So I'm second then.
Wow.
Is that what you're here? Yes.
Awesome.
Awesome.
This is the Atlantic Ocean?
Yes, ma'am.
This is where we were last night, man.
Yeah. Oh, you came here last night?
We came here last night,
yeah. I didn't see the ocean.
No, we couldn't. Well, it was dark.
Okay. I said I'm okay, but I couldn't say anything.
couldn't say anything, huh?
No,
speechless.
No, I couldn't say anything. Yes.
There's the ocean, darling.
Yes. That's where Robben Island. You see?
That's Robben Island over there?
Yes.
Okay. Gotcha. That's where we go tomorrow.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Wow.
They don't have sunbathing here.
No, ma'am. No. We go to the beach for them. This is the Cape Bay Hotel. That's where Michael Jackson was by the time he was in Cape Town.
Oh, really? Michael Jackson stayed there,
yes.
Huh? Cable Bay Hotel.
I will take you inside. That's what it's like.
What about when Obama? Did Obama come?
Obama, I don't know where he lived here.
Huh?
I wouldn't know. I'm just going to drive there the night.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
It's beautiful.
Very nice.
Big.
Big. Behind it is the waterfront, you know, where the boats are.
Uh-huh. Awesome. That's a,
No, we're just passing.
It's just tourists. Touristas. Thank you.
in there. Okay, we are lost.
Is that football stadium?
Yes, it's 2010. It was meant for 2010. Remember we had the World Cup here?
Oh, okay.
Yes. Football. Soccer.
Soccer.
Rugby, they call it, right?
Rugby is the other one.
The other one, yes. Yeah.
It's like your American football,
right?
Right.
Yeah. That's where we were last night. Over there.
Oh, yeah, the group?
No, we came over by ourselves. The hotel has a shuttle.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So we came over on the shuttle. Okay.
We had dinner, it was nice.
Yeah.
Good. So I've never tried some of the ostrich. I was going to give that a try. Is that delicious? Is it good?
Yeah, it's good.
They don't serve that in the United States.
Oh, the ice cream. You don't say what?
Ostrich.
Oh, ostrich, okay.
I was going to try that and curry. Uh-huh. Curry, I like curry.
Some people swim from there to here.
Really?
Yes.
Wow.
Professional swimmers.
Have you heard of a club called Drums?
Drums? No, I'm not sure about the
Drums.
It's Grand Beach.
Okay.
It's all the umbrellas. It's very nice.
So, essentially, since apartheid, you can do anything in South Africa as long as you can afford it? Is that true?
Yes.
The main thing is to vote. Who's the president now?
It's a guy called Ramaphosa.
See, a black man?
A black man, yes. He's still new and he's good. He sounds good. The other one was stealing from the people.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, no.
Guy called Zuma, yeah.
We got one that's nuts.
Mr. Trump.
Yeah.
Everybody knows that you are here.
We are embarrassed to be from America now.
Yes,
he has embarrassed us in front of the world.
I would love to see rugby. Do the teams play now? Is it time for that?
No, ma'am. You just missed it. But it was not here, by the way. It was in Johannesburg. Last week, yes. Victoria.
Oh, this is pretty. Is that the biggest industry here, tourism?
It's one of the biggest, yes, man.
What else do you have?
What else do we have? Oh. Tourism is number one.
You have military here?
No, it's in Samuelstown. Right? It's part of Cape Town, but out of Cape Town towards the Cape Point, you know, where the two oceans are meeting.
Uh-huh.
Yes. Have you heard of that one?
No.
Cape Point?
No.
That's where the Atlantic and Indian meet.
Ah.
At the bottom of Africa, you know?
Right.
Yes, the bottom tip.
Is that a control tower there? What is that?
No, it's a hotel restaurant, I bet.
Which one?
On top of the building that just disappeared behind that other building. Okay.
We should buy a bottle of wine for our trip.
Starbucks. No, I don't know.
You've never heard of Starbucks?
No.
Good.
They're not here yet.
Good.
Oh.
They're like McDonald's, only for coffee.
Oh, okay.
Look at that up ahead.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Is Is that where the rich people live?
Yeah, that's correct, man. That's correct. And that hill is called the Lion's Head.
The Lion's Head?
That's right.
So where's the best place to hear African music live?
Mama Africa.
Mama Africa.
Yes. One of them.
Where else?
Africa Cafe as well. That's in town as well.
Okay.
Yes. Those two.
Have you been there yourself?
Yeah, well, my nephew's in one of the bands that's singing there.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Which one? He's at Mama Africa?
Mama Africa, yes.
He's there. What's his name?
Kolani.
Kolani.
Kolani, yes.
Kolani, I'm gonna walk up to him and say Kolani.
So he's your uncle.
He's doing the bass, marimba.
Drum?
Marimba, yeah.
Oh, the marimba.
That's marimba, yes.
Oh, okay. Yes. Okay. I play in a band at home.
Do you?
Yes.
Oh, we are with a star here.
I'm amateur, I play flute.
Oh, amazing, man. I like flute, you know. But I cannot play it, it's a pity. Yes. How did you come? Did you learn this from school? Did you?
Stop and get a picture.
Okay.
No, I'm good. I'm good.
You okay?
Yeah.
All right.
I'm just going to drive slow as well.
Okay.
When you go around the corner,
they won't be able to stop there.
Yeah.
Those there are called the 12 apostles, those mountains there. They're 12 altogether.
The 12 apostles.
That's correct, man. Yes. 12 apostles.
You been to the top?
No, not on these ones. Is this Clifton? It's where the rich live as well.
I wished it was. That way he would be in the States.
Whale rock. You have whales here?
No. Very few whales here, you know. Seldom see them. The other side, that's where they are. Yeah. On the warm waters, you know, the Indian Ocean side.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
This is the Atlantic
Ocean.
Yeah,
too cold.
Huh? Yeah. Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's so cold. You put your foot there when it's 30 degrees outside, when you put your foot there, it's like it's something is cutting it off.
Really?
Yeah, it's
that
so cold.
Cold, huh?
Yeah. It's also cold.
I forget how far south we are. You know, near close to the South Pole, not too far.
Not too far. How many days are you going to be still here?
Well, we leave here Friday.
Okay.
And we go to Kruger Park.
Kruger
yeah.
Park, ah, good choice. Yes.
Yeah. Have you been there?
No, I haven't. No, but that's here. I hear everybody says they recommend it. You know, they think it's the best. So you get the big five as well.
Yeah, we fly to Johannesburg and then bus to Kruger.
Okay. Wow. It's gonna drive in here to come out.
Oh, there's little trees on top of that rock over there. Mm-hmm. It's wild.
Wow.
Yes. Go down here, there's a beach, fourth beach.
Oh, nice.
It's very nice.
You tap me, hon?
Only because I want you to look left.
Oh.
If I do this, look left.
All
if I
right.
do that, look right.
That's good.
What did I miss?
during December, you cannot drive like this here.
No?
Yes, lots of cars, you know, the traffic. People going to the beach and coming from the beach.
Ah.
Yes.
That is gorgeous.
And it's Camps Bay, you see there, of course.
Where do you go for barbecue?
The barbecue.
Where do you go for barbecue?
Waterfront?
No, where do you take your family for barbecue?
Oh, we don't go to restaurants, no. The expensive ones, no, we don't go.
I'm talking about good barbecue, good food, where you take your family.
Okay, that's next to your hotel there. To your hotel, there's a place there. That's where I take my family, you know, sometimes.
Where, in our hotel?
Yes, next to your hotel there.
Huh.
The Spur, it's called the Spur.
Sometimes the best places are not the hotels. Sometimes yeah. It might be a little shack, but the food
yes,
is good.
Yes, yes. Well, there's a number of good places around this area here that you can go to. A place called the Bungalow down the road, down on that side here. Very nice as well.
Is the water cold?
Very cold. Very cold.
You can stop here for some time, then you can
take a little walk.
No, I'm good. Yeah, we have to be back in the hotel in an hour. This is still considered Cape Town.
That's correct. It's Camsway, Cape Town. So popular with the tourists.
This would be a good hop-on-hop-on place.
Bay Hotel here, called the Bay Hotel.
This is Camp Bay.
That's correct, ma'am. Camp Bay. See the people here.
It's pretty.
There.
No.
Nope.
I
want to
walk on the beach.
You want
to
walk on the beach?
Okay. Okay. So we stop. Walk on the beach.
I can't come this far and walk on the beach.
I'm gonna stop somewhere there. Then.
Okay.
Just for 10 minutes, 5 minutes.
Okay. the one playing now, yes?
Yeah, she was married to...
Harry Belafonte.
Yeah, Harry Belafonte, yes. But then she was also married to...
Hugh Masekela.
Yeah,
yes.
Civil rights activist.
We've got about 45 minutes left. We have to be back at the hotel. Okay. Back there by 1:45. Our tour leaves at 2 o'clock.
Well, we're going to 2 o'clock. Two
yes.
Bus.
Okay. Yes.
We're going to the township today.
You're going to the township today?
Township.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's a good idea.
A lot of construction going on.
Yes.
Hopefully a lot of jobs.
Yes. Okay.
That's too much wind, let me know, friend.
It's a lot.
How's that?
That's better. Hey, I could have just spent the day at the beach.
I know. Any beach.
Nah, that beach is nice. It's warm out there, too.
Uh-huh. We get the sun warming the sand. Okay. Water situation here now?
It's much better now.
Much better?
Yes. We had lots of rain. It's good. Although it came late, but still.
Still conservation measures are in effect?
Yes, very much so. This is green.
Yeah. Woman thing?
Man, woman thing.
The women are less threatening?
Yes, they are Westerns. I'm not going to enjoy them. I'm not going to enjoy them.
is your name, by the way?
Victor.
Victor?
Yes.
Your last name?
Magopeni.
Magopeni. Victor Magopeni.
I'm Kosa.
Kosa, okay.
Kosa, yes. Kosa. My name was Kosa, too. Our tribe.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
How many languages do you speak?
Four languages.
Really?
Yes.
Which are?
English, Kosa, bit of Afrikaans, Zulu, Sotho, more than four.
Wow.
Yes.
Desmond Tutu's church.
Yes, that's right.
Let's go in.
Kosa.
Let's go in.
Honey, we don't have time, darling. Mm. We.
This quarter after, we're right around the corner from the hotel.
How far are we from the hotel?
It's about 4-5 streets down the way.
Slave Lodge.
The Slave Lodge, yes.
Museums of South Africa. Yeah, we'll have some tomorrow afternoon. After Robben Island, huh?
Okay. That's where I want to come.
Okay.
I want to go to that museum, the slave museum.
Mm-hmm. All right.
They don't have that in the United States.
Oh.
No slave museum. They don't want to acknowledge that they brought slave
Because that guy there is going to charge me money when he sees.
Which tour did y'all do?
Take them out in the city tour.
Oh, okay.
How was the city tour? It was nice.
I mean, they had to bring the Jamaican baddies from somewhere, right? Hopefully it came from Africa, right?
I thought it did.
You know those are good, right? Oh, my goodness.
How long have you been in Cape Town?
We just got in yesterday.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And then there's one called...
Yes. It's beautiful.
Tasties. Which one do you like better?
So how many more days you
play? Well, we're here till...
Yeah, I think I gotta go to Tasties later.
We leave early Saturday morning.
But now I'm a Tasties girl.
Okay.
Yes!
This is still gonna be around.
I got an auntie. She makes them, though.
Oh, that's the one.
So we got a few days to look, you know.
She passed on. And,
so far, only.
But I can't make
what time you arrived yesterday?
I can't make
we got into that's town it, probably it. Around
it, it
two-ish.
Doesn't work at all.
In the afternoon. In the afternoon, okay.
Yeah.
So nothing much, you see.
No, we went to the waterfront last night.
What's this place here?
Had dinner.
Mm-hmm.
And then we took a self-guided tour here with a cab driver this morning.
No,
yeah.
We just hung out on the beach for a little bit. We did we hired a driver.
Okay.
And he took us, you know, and did a city tour already. So
yes, essentially.
We went to 12 apostles.
Have you been in, there's a place called
Walk Up? More than 12 to me.
No.
Okay.
Yeah, and you're doing a Shark Tank tomorrow, right?
No, it's cake tomorrow.
Oh, you're doing a cake.
Are you guys doing that?
Yeah,
yeah, right. Yeah, I want to see pictures with you, with limbs and without, right?
No, no, no. I would do it, you know. But we got the peninsula tour that day because we had to switch it.
Oh, you had to switch it.
Yeah, because we're doing round and round.
Any significance to the buildings, the colors?
The reason of the colors, because of these guys, they were brought here back in the days as slaves, and then after 1994, that is when they would get the title deeds to own these houses. Now each and every family was so proud finally to get to own them. So they wake up and try to put them to, it's kind of expressing themselves from freedom.
Ah, okay.
You know what, these trees amaze me, these little trees on the mountains. They're so beautiful.
So far.
Okay, we'll get to the other side. Huh?
Yes.
It's a hot mess, huh?
But I have two names.
Okay.
My native name is Begisisa.
Begisisa.
Yes, that's my native name. I grew up that time, you know, we're coming such a bad time of apartheid. I did grow up that time where English name was kind of being forced to have. So that's why I have two names. So that means that was back in the days that we were, when you're starting at school, you were forced to have English name, or when you were baptized, you were forced to have English name, or when you're starting a job, you were kind of forced to have English name. That was before. But today, most of our kids, they have one name. So in that generation also of Nelson Mandela as well, he also has two names, like me. But sad part, his native name is not so famous. Of which his native name is Kholihlahla. That is his native name. That was given from his birth, from his mother. Kholihlahla. Kholihlahla.
Kholihlahla.
Kholihlahla, yes.
Kholihlahla.
That's the meaning of, that's the name of Mandela. That's his native name when he was given birth from his mother. Of which Nelson was get from school by his teacher. Because she also couldn't pronounce Kholihlahla.
She didn't want to.
She didn't want to, yes, to pronounce Kholihlahla. That's when she decided to give him Nelson. So now, sad part also, when he get back and tell his mother that I have a new name by Nelson. But now his mother couldn't pronounce Nelson as well. She used to call him Nelisiwe. So that's why I also have these two names. But my two sons, they have only one native name. But that was back then. So that's why I have two names. Always people ask why you have two names. This is the reason why I have two names.
So how old are you?
I'm 40. I'm going to turn 43 this Friday.
So, happy birthday. Happy birthday.
So when was apartheid over?
Official over from 1994. I would say that was official over.
Okay.
But there were breaks or like little bit break that started from 85.
Was that similar to slavery in America?
It was not really slavery, but it was the treatment that was people were have to live under the fear whenever you saw the police, you don't know where it's going to arrest you. There were so many people who have been arrested with no justice. So that is how people were treated, with no rights. But not as slavery, but there was black people had no right at all. So this is how, and this is why also apartheid took so long. But now, this tour that we are doing, it's about that. I will take you to the journey from the beginning till today.
Let me ask you one other question. Did they force you to work?
No, it was not a force. It was a must, because people, they grew up in the villages where they used to plow their own vegetables. But after some times, they're having a drought of which they couldn't able to produce their own food. And today, we always heard so many stories around our forefather, how they lost also even their live cattle. We hear stories about Nongauza, some lady that she was a prophet, that she was told to people to go, people, they must send their cows in the sea. There will be no more land. But it's just stories, because of, as a result, people end up being slavery of working. Of which back in the days they were never wanted to work, because they used to travel around with their own cattle, planting their own corn. But now, after some time, things slightly changes. So this is how, like, as in general. But even these cities like Cape Town, it was developed from the beginning by the slaves. Of which now, and historically, things started from 1652, when Jan van Riebeeck, they came with three ships. They used to use Cape as a refreshment stop when they're trying to find a way to India from Europe. But a Dutch East Indian Company, they decided to settle in the Cape. That was, they came with three ships. That was only men, yes, that time. And they settled in the Cape. So that's how things started. So when they settled, they used to, they brought slaves from Malaysia, Madagascar, India, to build the city as it is today. But back in the days, the slavery was abolished in 1800. Then that is when they have to use native people from the country. Although there were those wars against the land, but sometimes in the long run they defeated, and then that's when they end up also find a way to find employment. So where we are now, this area, it was called Malay quarters. Malay quarters, for those who were brought here from Malaysia, Madagascar, as slaves from the beginning. This is where they were living, in this compound. But after 1800, slavery was abolished. So this is where now they can able to practice their culture. There's a lot of mosques and the kramats now, because they are free. So they can practice their religions as well. This is the only place that was left. Hence, further down, there's an area called District 6, where black, white families were moved by force out of the city. So that was under the law, was created by the government of apartheid. That was called Group Areas Act. So as we are South Africa, we are also have three nations, which is we have those so-called black, colored, and white. I'm a black. A colored, this nation of colored, it was established after 1652, as remember, these men, they came sailing almost over the month. So when they arrive in the earth, they spot some beautiful African woman. After 9 months, then this nation is called Colored was born. So this is how this nation of Colored was able to born by. As a result, it's a mixed race. That's what they call in South Africa, Colored. And then there's a white. Even in the white, we have two different whites. We have white English spoken from England. who have white Afrikaans spoken from the Dutch. So it's divided in that way. That's why we end up also having 11 official languages. In blacks also, we are different, but we're all blacks in terms of tribe in blacks. In South Africa, we had 9 tribes. But we're all black, but we have 9 tribes. Of which the 2 biggest tribes, it's called is Zulu and Xhosa.
What's the second one?
Xhosa.
Xhosa.
So I'm a Xhosa. And the Zulu also, that these are the 2 biggest tribes within the country. Here in the Western Cape, which is Cape Town, is dominated by the Xhosas. Hence now South Africa is also divided into 9 provinces, which is Cape Town is called Western Cape. As you're looking at our map, is at the end. So on the other side of Indian Ocean, it's Eastern Cape, Durban. And further down, this is Western Cape. As you go up in the north, there's provinces like Limpopo, Northwest, Northern Cape, Pretoria, Johannesburg we call it now, Gauteng, and Durban. So these are one of the Free State, these are Venda, those are the provinces that in the inland. So in terms of these tribes also, you find each province is dominated by 1 or 2 tribes. So if you go to Durban, you'll find more Zulu. As you go further down, in terms of black population, you find more Xhosas in Western Cape. The reason why there's influence in the Western Cape, because of it's close. This is where, back in the days, our people never liked the weather here. They never migrated when they were used to migrate around because of the weather. Here we have a Mediterranean weather. So people didn't like this weather of this Western Cape. So there was not so much rain as well. Even the sand was not so rich in order to plow anything. So that's why they were never interested in migrating in this side. What makes us to migrate this side? Because of now we couldn't produce a food. And then this city was developed. And they need a migrant laborers. That's when they have to recruit people from the villages to work and build these cities. As a result, in the long run, they discover a gold and diamond in Johannesburg. And then Johannesburg was developed because they were also needing migrant laborers as well. At some point today, Johannesburg is a big city because of it also has more land, more resources, minerals that is in Johannesburg. But in terms of shipping, now it's Cape Town that is mainly, and Durban, because we are close to the sea. And then Johannesburg is inside in England. But there's still more minerals in Johannesburg. So now, back in the days when these cities were developed, they were needing men only from the natives that were recruited out from the villages that works in these cities. Now, the township now today we're gonna visit different townships. This is the one only for the Muslim community that were brought here from the beginning as slaves from those areas. And then we visited Langa, which is the only 100% black lives in Langa. This is where I live. This is where I grew up. And then the colored community as well. We're gonna able to see the differences. Even the treatment during those days, when these men working, if you're working this company, maybe I would drive this bus as a white person, you will earn 10 rand. For black person, same bus, you will earn, a colored will earn 5 rand. And then the black person will earn two rand, but you drive the same bus.
I didn't understand what you just said.
Yes. I'm making example the treatment the way it was. Like these men who came here for work, they will work for the same company.
But pay different?
Pay different.
Pay different.
Yeah. The white will in 10 rand.
Oh.
And then the colored will in 5 rand. And the black will in 2 rand.
Oh, that's messed up.
But we were doing the same thing.
It's like women and men in America.
Yes. So this is how things are today.
Same?
No, it's changed. But this is how before. Now, it was also not easy to spot a colored person. Because some of them, they also influenced it with their own language, which is Afrikaans. So there were experiment, they call it a pencil test. A pencil test, they will put, I don't have hairs, they will put it here.
Right.
On my hairs. And they will say that I must fall, look down. If it falls, then I'm a colored.
What?
Yes. If it's stuck, I'm a black.
Really?
Yes. That's how they used to use that system as a pencil test to spot a colored and a black. So the colored were saved by that pencil test not to in 5 rand. I mean, not to in 2 rand. So now as we will drive these townships, you will spot these differences. Even the kind of homes they have, you can see who was in it more than other one.
They're making more money, they can afford better.
Yes. Right. They can live better.
That's so what happened. They came.
Yeah. This is why now we will spot today these differences as we will come, we'll drive along the townships. So, but in terms of these men who were starting to live in this township, they were brought here to stay in barracks. Langa, we still have more barracks, such because they were only men staying, living, working. Only they were allowed to visit their home 2 times a year. That was the Easter's and then Christmas. That's when, living in 1,000 kilometers away their families, where they can only allowed to visit them 2 times a month. That was Eastern Cape. Most of the men now are working, living in the Western Cape.
And they worked?
They work here, building this building that you see, and then they stay in the barracks in the township, and then Easter and December, that's the time then they will visit their families. I also never born in this province. Many people were not born in this province, they were born in Eastern Cape. I was born to that side. I grew up myself experiencing that life. My father was working in Johannesburg.
In the mines?
He was working in the construction. He was lucky because most men were working in the mines. But I would say he was lucky because most men were working in the mines that were so dangerous even that time. Even his brothers, they died in Joburg, in the mines. But he also died in Joburg, but he fell in the building. So he used to come to visit us only in December. That time I thought it's normal. I didn't know that was the law. That was the reason why he couldn't able to come the weekend. Because from Eastern Cape to Joburg is about 8 hours drive by car.
No, Joburg is Johannesburg?
Johannesburg, yes, sorry.
Okay, Joburg.
Okay. Yeah, it's just Johannesburg, yeah. And then after 1985, people were usually controlled in the cities by the system of the pass laws, where people had to carry passes. But that you will see when you get to Langa, we still have those offices that used to issue out those passes. They were even called dompas that was issued towards the black. Such dompas, each man, when you have it, you carry it 24/7. If you go to town, it must be in your pocket. Even if you go to church, Even if you go to store around you, it must be always in your pocket, because the police were always patrolling around.
Searching, white police.
Yes, white police. Searching for those who didn't have. Because no man was not allowed, even here, without a job. Even it was a thick book like this, with many pages in it. Each page has to be signed monthly by your employer to state that you still have currently a job. That was the way to control the movement, the influx in these cities. So that was not creating that feeling. There were black police also, but they were needing them for a language.
To speak, to translate.
Yeah, to translate. Even they won't take you a short guy, they will take you a tall and big. That was a qualification to be a police. But many people, they did take that job, because when you have that job, at least the treatment will be slightly better for you. Right. And also for your family. Right. And then you can able also to bring your family, because you are the policeman. While other men cannot bring their family and stay with them. So, till 1985, these past laws were abolished. Even it was not just a past laws, also it was there were border gates in between the provinces. If you come out today, they used to call it Eastern Cape, Transkei and Ciskei back in the days. So if you come up from Transkei, where also was born, even Mandela was born in Transkei, there were border gates. If you go to Joburg, there were border gates. If you go to Cape Town, you must had produced, because there were agencies that recruiting those men in the villages. So without a letter of approval, it wouldn't come through. That was not easy to move around in the country back in the days. That is when 1985, this, but there were protests, but I'll tell you more as we get to the museum in Langa about the protest that was started by women, and then the second protest was done in 1960, but it never make impact till the world observed, and then they were sanctioned in South Africa. And then 1985, they released a little bit. These dompas were abolished, and then border gates were removed. That was the time when many families came able to move and enjoy living with their families in the city. So as from 1985, 86, slowly people moving to the cities. But for me, I was not lucky, because my father, he died in 86. Mm. He fell in the building. And then my mother, her father was working in Cape Town. So she decided to move to her father so that she can able to find a job.
Did she have problems moving with the pass?
It was a problem, because it was still not that time, it was still new. This, no one, there was still some police are taking advantage of people. Even she was working in Constantia on other side as a domestic work. Her boss, most of their bosses, they have to hide them at the back of their yard, not traveling around. Because should they travel, they'll become victim of being arrested, where you must always pay bribes towards the police in order to be safe. Till 1990, when Mandela was released out of the prison, that was a time when the population grew so high in the cities. That's the time when we figure out now, our father or grandfather who are staying in this city, they were accommodated in these dormitories. Such dormitories that was designed for single men, not for families. Where you find one room or one bedroom sharing four men or three men. Now, bear in mind, now these men can, they were started to be allowed to bring them families. They first share in this hostel, but the situation was very awkward to share now with families. It was okay when it was just men. But now there's two genders, there's female, there's male, there's children. That is when, as if you arrive from the airport, You saw spot those little tiny homes that are built near highways.
Yeah.
It's because of the population of the people moving from the villages to the city. And they do need some form of privacy. They end up building themselves by force to the land. Also, they say it belongs to government. So it was not easy to build also those homes. At first, they built, they attached into these dormitories or these barracks. But the population was still growing. That is when people end up spot any vacant land that is close by and they go build these homes. We usually build these homes over the night when the police is not visible. Before 1986 and 94, the police, they used to come and destroy them. But when they are gone, we keep building again. So that was the only material that was, I would say it was, it easy to quick and build.
Mm-hmm.
Because the bricks, it will take time. And it was a strategy of invading. So that's why they are built with this material. And even if they destroy today, tomorrow I can still build again.
Right.
So that's why they are all looking like that. Even some of them, if you notice, they were built nicely before they were destroyed. And then you keep building it again. You will never get very nice because we done these homes overnight. Not because maybe sometimes we think maybe people are not so talented, but bear in mind they destroy today, when they are going to build it again. So it can never been looked nicely.
Right.
Because it's been destroyed many times and then keep built many times. So till 1994, after 1994, our new government, when they took over Nelson Mandela, and then they saw this was a bad image of looking people's homes being destroyed. And people, they need a place to stay. They need to restore the human dignity of the people. And then they put this law, says, if you find someone in an existing structure, you're not supposed to remove that person. If you do so, make an alternative land for that family. Wow. That law, that was a law that now allows us, we use it against the government to build quick as possible the homes. And this law, it says within 48 hours, if you succeeded within 48 hours, then that spot is yours forever.
Really?
Yeah. That is why now we usually build this home overnight. And you can never build it again with the bricks. Because, yes, we can build it with bricks if it was, you can manage it in 48 hours, but you can't. It's not possible with
right.
the bricks. That's why we're still keeping it, building in the way, old traditional way of using the zinc material and the wood. That is quicker to build.
And then they have something.
And then you have something forever.
Right.
And then don't need to pay no rent anymore.
Right. Cool. All right. I understand.
Once you invade it, then it's yours forever. That spot is yours. Then you don't need to pay any rent. But still, not entitled for the land yet.
Okay.
So that's why we cannot also continue build it nice with the bricks. But at least we have a land. When they're thinking to develop the area, then we have a spot at least.
So then, they keep track of the materials you use to build the structure?
Yeah, they buy sometimes in the warehouse.
Say, oh, this is nicer than it was yesterday?
Yeah, but now, today, they saw that land grabbing is happening too much. They protected their land by having a new law enforcement, it's called Metropolis. Today, are patrolling every day. They don't give us any chance to invade. But we only target every 5 years with election. That year before election and the election year, that's the time we target, because the politicians are soft.
Okay.
So that means now every 5 years we always have new election, a new township.
Township. Wow.
But only this applies within the city, because I grew up in the village. We don't buy land.
when you're at the stage of marriage and stage of wanting to have your own family, you approach the chief will cut you a land. That is why many people refuse to buy land. Because in the same country, and then you tell me now, is it because it's the city, I must buy land. Even the land, it's so expensive. And not many people are educated. They do work, but they can't afford to buy houses. Mm. Because houses in the city are so huge, expensive.
Like what?
Like, if you buy a decent house, it's about 700,000. Bear in mind, still minimum wage is still little. Around 2,500 a month. So where, how can you afford house? At some point, some of these people are still have homes in the villages. And that they're still taking care of them. So that when they retire, they go back. Even now, if you ever come during December, of which Christmas, in the our township are empty. All people are gone back in their villages. In the city, the only thing that they need to make money. Hence, in the city, in the village, there's no work. So that is one of the reason situation like this. Okay, let's keep continuing. Just forget my mark now. I talk when I stop. So that everyone
so
can...
you know what, that whole stencil test thing forced the colors and the blacks to be separated too.
Yeah, absolutely.
Just keep everybody heat.
Survive to stay close to the city, and the rest of us were forcibly removed out.
Are these people Asian or black?
Asian, yes.
Malaysians.
Yeah. Muslim. They practice. There's a lot of mosque as well. They were painting their homes, as you see, after 1994, when they gained also these homes, their homes to be not rented, to be finally owned them. So it was the way to express themselves with freedom. Is Xhosa, which is my home language, as well as Afrikaans, the one is a bit more Dutch. Look at those are written in that board next to this government building. Can you see?
Yes.
There's three. The first, our language, and the second, English, the last, Afrikaans, that are written the same thing
right
over the wall. Of which my language is famous with the clicks. But the only three clicks that you hear when you speak. That is letter C. Those three are the most famous click sounds when you're speaking. Maybe you hear a lot of them, people speaking like that way. Like in my last name is Gweta. That's my last name.
Second?
Gweta. So my full name is Gladstone Pegisisa Gweta.
Right.
Those are written in my identity card. So most of our names usually always has meaning. The meaning of Pegisisa means look clearly. That's the meaning of my name. Do you know the meaning of famous man? Hence, our names, usually our parents, they have a ways of seeing your children when he's born that, hey, this boy maybe is going to be naughty, or this boy gonna, you know, all those wish or Tatola. Or Tatola, that is letter C.
And most of the people we see walking the streets here live in the township?
Yes. Everyone, most, almost, I would say 85% people that you see are living in the township, working in these offices. Our parliament is just on this side.
So how do they get back and forth to work?
We have trains and buses, as well as this little white van like this one,
uh-huh,
that transport people from township to here.
Is that expensive to get back and forth to work?
Yes, it's very expensive.
Right?
Very expensive. And at that time now, the transportation is still very poor, because you'll find that they will stuck in the road. We have a lot of traffic. But still living in the city is so highly expensive. Yes, now anyone can live here, but it's just a matter of money, financially, it's so expensive. See, even the children are studying here in the city, but they're still gonna use the same transport to go back home. We do have schools in the townships, but you find out they are so crowded. Now parents have to work hard to send their kids into schools like in town, and then now it will cost them also money for transport. Darling Street. This is the most street that is famous for festival. Also, this is a famous about, we have our civil wall that we're gonna be able to pass through, where Nelson Mandela, when the first time was released out from the prisoner, this is where he delivers his first speech in the crowd. Thousands of people were coming to welcome him. Where he was preaching about forgiveness. But not many people really thought it's a good idea. Till today that we are living in his legacy. Where he was always preaching us, telling us, let's forgive, and but not forget. Let's build this new South Africa to be a rainbow nation for everyone. Today, I would say he did a very best thing, because today, yes, we're living still have issues in terms of financial, but people are now living with peacefully. As you know, many countries like Rwanda in Africa, many African countries, they have a lot of civil war. Like, this is where, if you look at this statue here on your right, can you see?
Yes.
That is where he was standing when he was delivering the first speech with the crowd here that was coming to welcome him as he was delivering his first speech in 1990. That was in 1990 on the 11th of February. Now we are going to drive through in this land or in this place where used to be called District 6 Municipality. District 6 Municipality, this is where it used to be a community that was used to live as black, colored, white, Indian. Everyone was living in this area before segregation. But the last removal, it happened in 1966 on the 11th of February, when the area was declared only for the white can stay next to the city. The rest must move away as far as 15 kilometers away from the city. And then all their homes were totally destroyed.
Oh my God.
And they were all forcibly removed out of the city. Under that law was called Group Areas Act. So now as we're starting, this is the land. Besides, some few homes were built and schools were built. But as you spot this open field, that shows you used to be a people's homes in this open field that you see some of them. This land was just recently built, some of the building. As you see now, this going to build another building here, but before it was open field. And then we have also a university, of which this area was having their own universities, their own schools, their own churches, their own mosque. Hence now, when these homes were totally demolished, but what they never demolished in their schools. Their schools are still remaining. Their churches are still remaining. And the rest of the homes were totally destroyed. Because they knew that if they destroyed those things, apartheid was not all, everyone was supporting it. So probably also afraid of God as well, maybe. Uh-huh. That's why the churches are still remaining. As you spot now, this open field, this is used to be homes. And this is a school, a university, on your right. There's a mosque. Yeah, it's still in use. You see, there's a Catholic church. You see, instead of demolishing this, they built a school around it. And now, recently, after 1994, between 2000, they decided to compensate for those families who lost their land or their homes by starting to build this apartment, the white ones. But they are still in the process of being built. As you look at on your right, there's more have been built for the ones that lost their lives. I mean, their homes in the site.
Is this for the blacks?
It's mixed. But it's hard for the blacks because they were the first one to be moved out. Yeah. As early as 1901. And now they say that we must bring proof. Such proof now we don't have.
Yeah, how do you get it?
How do you get a proof? Yeah,
all right.
As you still spot these open scars here. That used to be people's homes. But the reason why there's still open like scars like this, because after the demolition of people's homes, no companies was interested on building in the land. As you see, there's some church there. All these kids are coming from township, but they're still coming expensive. The only thing that is expensive in a semi-private is transport.
Okay.
So, as you see, the yellow building was one of the college of District 6. All of these. As tells you, there's still kids now are studying, coming from townships. Look at the school buses.
Now the whites here in their homes employ blacks as domestic help?
Yeah, many of like those who have no career in terms of they never had an opportunity to go with their careers, like they can get a decent job. Because at some point, at many of the in the villages, there were no schools. So that this street that has a carbon road, that was a street that used to be the community that used to stay where black families that used to live in the street. Of which they were the first ones to be moved out, 1901. And then the rest colored were moved later in 1966. So now at some point now, it's for the black people, it's not easy to come back here. Because I've heard also my grandfather, he used to stay here, but we have no proof. So there's no point of saying now because it's complicated in that way.
They have barbed wire fences here? Why?
It's to secure the school.
Uh-huh.
This is a school down here. You see there's still a mosque here?
Okay.
Behind that school, that shows that was used to be. They built in the land that used to be people's community where they used to stay around these churches.
No, they have to protect the school. That's why they have this barbed wire, because there's a lot of equipment that can get stolen.
Is crime very high in this area?
Yeah, it's very, very high. And yes, one of another primary school, high school of District 6, can still spot it even today.
How about drug use amongst the blacks here?
Drug use is also becoming slowly developing. The drug is called it's the crystal meth. Yeah. That I see in future is going to be a problem, but it's already affecting a lot of colored community. But in our black community, still something that is developing, but it's not still huge. But you'll see as we go to Langa.
Usually that's driving the increases in crime, so I asked.
Oh.
Where you have crime, you normally have drugs as a pusher.
Other drugs, maybe probably like other drugs that are expensive, people still cannot afford them. These are also only apartments that were left. They were survived from being demolished, these ones.
So
but
now,
the reason why these ones, they were placed whites, and they were also used them as to shield from the view, because this is a road that is busy devolved coming from the airport. So it was worked as a shield. What makes also, as you are here now, between 1700s, these homes on top there was nothing beside these ones. There was some, so as you look at now, this view that they were fighting for, this beautiful mountain, you see, on your right, next to the harbor. That is what they were so anxious, they wanted ships by upgrading shacks, also by upgrading barracks. But at some point, some people are not longer interested on moving back because they already settled in their townships.
Now I noticed children walking. I would assume they live close enough to walk from their school, is that it?
Yeah, some few of them. They're living on those...
That view is gorgeous.
Yeah. This used to be all people's homes around here. As you spot now, there's nothing at all.
Wow.
Till that road up there. So these are the buses that they just use this area because it's not been used as to park these buses. During now the peak hour, they'll go down to the bus terminal to pick up the people, because in the city there's no enough space to park them. Now we're going to visit Langa. Of which Langa is the first black township that was created before removal. That time was created for these migrant laborers. Langa established 1923. As a result, it was just men working, living in Langa as migrant laborers. There were around 84 barracks, where you find each barracks accommodate 24 men.
What was Soweto?
Soweto is in another big city, Johannesburg. It's a township that was the first one in Johannesburg, as for black people. In Cape Town is Langa, that is the first one. It's 11 million.
Compared about 4 million here?
Yeah, 4 million here. So that shows how big Johannesburg is.
Once the apartheid ended, how would Afrikaans treat it? Was it like protest against them, or it was just like they just continued to live in the city? Let's just move on, like nothing happened?
to Australia, to England, from the city. This is where people have been moved into as black township in Cape Town. It is the first black township here that we just arrived. Now, this is one of the, this apartment you see in front, these all been built by our government.
What's that on top?
It's solar geyser. Solar geyser to heat up the water. Solar panels to heat up the water because they have lots of sun. So they're deciding to install us. These all built by government to compensate for those who are living in the barracks and for those who are living in these little corrugated small houses as shacks. Now they will be living in these homes.
How do they get in? How do they go from that to that? Is it a lottery or?
Yeah, they're developing different parts. They first start with old parts, and then the second part as it goes. But it goes with a queue. You apply and then you wait in the waiting list.
Sorry. No point.
Now, welcome to Langa. So as you look at now, these are the homes. Look at this one is right in Fanta. It's been developed. And the second one, as you see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, till up to number 55. See, each of these are different homes. And now you see some of these homes are not been extended, but those are still original as it was given by old former government for those families who were part of being segregated out of the city. And in terms of also we have high employment rate, around 50% people are not working. And the population in Langa is around 150,000 people.
Wow. Satellite TV over there.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
you got a cable.
Right. People want to watch sport. Yeah. And now, if you look at on your right, this is still original as hostel. But these were the first lucky one to be moved into those new apartment.
Wow.
You see how tiny it is? Bear in mind now, if it was, now, that time it was one single quarters as for single men. But now, the reason they're taking off the roof and the doors, because they don't want, they want to restore these old ones as for the future. As you know, we cannot erase the history. So, but they have to take off the roof and the doors, and the rest of those families already moved out into those new apartments. We have also a swimming pool on your left. This is a public swimming pool on your left. And these are the kids coming from schools. We have in Langa about 5 primary schools, as well as we have 4 high schools. As you see them, they're all wearing uniform.
You're saying Longa, L-O-N-G-A, Longa?
Say?
L-O-N-G-A, Longa.
Langa.
Langa.
Langa. Langa. Langa means sun also in English.
L-A-N-G-A?
Yes.
Langa.
Langa. Now, must they go to school? Is it required that every child go to school?
Yes, it's required. Every child has
strutting his thing.
Seatbelts, no restrictions on
the
men.
You know him?
I know everyone. I know him, he's my friend. He's the one that is parking there.
Cool.
And now, if you look at on your right, here, this is where used to be homes like this. Ah. And they were the first one to move there into those new apartments. So they're gonna continue building some more of those apartments for these people.
So when they first displaced them here, did they build them these little shacks, or they just said go there and figure it out?
They first built in that open field those apartments. After that, they were all moved into there. And then these are the left one. So these one, they are waiting for that open field to be built so that they can move into the new apartment.
as you look at now these ones, how tiny they are. Yeah. So these are kind of extension from the original hostel. Because these families are living here, this is where their father used to live in this dormitory. And now after 1985, these men can be allowed to be joined by their families. That is when these homes were born. These houses were developed after 1990. These little corrugated iron houses.
After 1990?
Yes, after 1990. Before it was just this compound as accommodating single men. Look at now this building in the middle. It's toilets that they're still sharing this side and that side as a dormitory. They share, yeah. They still share this toilet.
Do they
from
have
this side and that side?
Do they have bathrooms, showers?
Yeah, we do have public showers around Langa, but not in this area. But it's not far. I think it's 3 minutes walk from here.
Really?
Public shower. Excuse me.
So you share? Is it shared washroom?
Yeah, these ones. This because these homes, these are the one. Remember that was created for the migrant laborers. From the beginning, and then later they were joined by their families. So we have these different people around in our community. We have these kind of guys who come as men, and then we have these ones were brought out from the city as families. These when we started in those homes I was showing you, those were the homes that were built by old former government for those families were part of being segregated out of the city. And these ones were brought here from the beginning as to work. And then later they were joined by their families. And then these ones, they also have another alternative homes in the villages. But here they just need to make money. Because living in this compound is free. It's free in a sense, just it's not necessary to pay.
How about utilities like gas and electric? Is there electricity here?
Yeah, each and every house has electricity.
Okay.
Even this, except at some new parts, when the shacks are new, maybe sometimes they do struggle a little bit to get electricity. But in the long run, they do eventually get it.
Do they pay for the electric?
Yeah,
okay.
They're using electric meter boxes.
Okay.
Each that they installed into these houses.
There's not enough room for a bed. This just looks like a sit. You know, you sit.
Mm. Yeah.
Maybe a chair and a table.
Where do you sleep? Do you lay on the floor? I mean.
No, they do have now beds. That's why they're extending it with these little sheds.
Okay.
To get a little bit much bigger.
So once you move into a property, are you able to move to another or better after?
Yeah.
A while,
once you move those ones, the new ones.
Uh-huh.
After 7 years, you own them. And then you can do, you can make it better, or can move into other. That's what people. You find that most people in the township, they don't work the way out, they build the way up in the township. Look at these homes.
Okay.
Look at this one, I've been extended already. You see some of them, that shows, you can spot which one is working, which one is not working.
Yeah,
this one here, 21 is nice.
Yeah, so that means that guy is working. 33, still original, and then next to it, these were built in a form of two-room family house. But at least they have a little long backyards.
Yeah.
Right.
So these are the people that have no connection in anywhere. These were the ones that were brought from outside. As you look at, there's a tent there. See the tent? Because someone passes away in that house. So now since every last week, they do a prayer. Like to console the family. So since the homes are not enough, and then this weekend, that person will be buried. But now you have to hire a tent so that when the people coming to do the church service, it's 1 hour church service from 7 till 8 for whole week. And then Saturday, it's funeral.
So which ones did they have to build in 48 hours?
Those little corrugated iron houses.
Okay.
Let's visit one of the school, Tembani Primary School here.
So they're planting their own vegetable.
What percentage of the kids go to college?
Now, I would say the number, at least now, is starting to increase a little bit. Because now our government now they're starting at least to put some edu loans in and the loans to provide for each per child.
Just for us?
I don't know.
Just for us?
Just for us, maybe. Oh, they're so cute.
Thank you.
Yeah.